folks. Well, I wanted to put a TV in my van. I wanted to make this the Hammers and Jam van, so I can go around town and pull the TV out either the back door or around the side door to show the videos that we do and get to know some of the locals. So I come up with this. I have a 32-inch TV, and I found this 400-watt power inverter, that will plug in to my adapter in the back of the truck. And I've tried it out already, it works great. And this is kind of an odd surface to mount something on, so I'm going to have to come up with some kind of a wooden surface to, because this isn't flat, this sticks out here and it's going to have to go all the way across. So I think I'm going to do is go ahead and cut two pieces of wood that fit in here, screw those in with some metal screws, and then take another sheet flush over the top of it to give me a larger flat surface to mount the TV mount on. And the TV mount that I got, it'll pull 40 inches off of that wall, which I think it's amazing. So I just hope that when it's all said and done that it actually does what I need it to do. So let's get started. All right, so I got my tape measure here. And I'm gonna just, like I said, from here to here, it's got a little bit of a taper to it, so I'll cut it a little big and then trim it in. But it looks like we're gonna need something around 12 and a half. Yeah, I'm gonna go a little short, 14 and three quarter. 12 and a half by 14 and three quarter. I'm gonna need two pieces. I'm going to use half inch. That'll get us past this little bump. All right, I'll be right back.
That's 12 and a half.
Now, what I'm going to do is I need to kind of eyeball this, trace this in a little bit here. So if I set this up here, I can kind of see where I need to cut off. And I just go like that. That'll take care of that and nip that corner there, and that'll be fine. And then that should work for the other side too, so I'm gonna cut both of them just like that. See how easy? Watching me wrong. Nah, I got this. Okay, so I got my mark on the one. What I'm gonna do, let's just hold the two together, cut them both at the same time. Because I can. Two pieces. Piece of cake, right? Alright, let's see what we got here. So, that piece will go there. That'll be just fine. And if it works on this side, it should work on this side, right? Well, that was the idea, and apparently they're not the same. So, I'm going to have to just alter one of them. No big deal. Okay, so I got a bag of goodies here. Since we have metal here, and you can see, if you look close here, you can see that there's space between this lip and the outer. So I have something to screw into without going through. You don't want to go through this, trust me. So you gotta be extra careful. So I got some screws that are just big enough to go through and grab the metal and not go through the other side. So let's, I'm gonna go ahead and pre-drill some of these and see if they go in. No, they'll go in. I'm a little nervous about getting a screw up toward the top because this back panel, what it does is it tapers tighter. It gets closer to this other piece I'm screwing to as it goes up, and I'm afraid I'm gonna go through the outside. I don't think it could go through the outside, but it's definitely gonna dent it if I go up high. So what I'm gonna do is just put some ones here low, right around here. Now when I put the centerpiece up, I can screw the centerpiece together with the ones I just put on and get some fasteners down the middle here on this larger piece. And I think that'll be sufficient. Let's do it. Right about there. Check the outside, make sure we're good. Looks fabulous. All right. Excellent. Let's do the other one. That always makes me nervous going through the outside of this stuff, you know? No one wants to put holes in their truck that they got a patch. One more. Here we go. That's pretty tight. All right. I'll be right back. Stay tuned. So I went ahead and I cut this other board here to go over this. Of course, these screws are going to be in the way, so I have to cut these out. So I just set this up here. This board doesn't have to cover everything. I just want to, right? So like that. And if I cut out that circle right there, then those screws won't be in the way, and this board will sit flat. And then I'm going to try to mount the TV mount in here. I'm starting to get a little nervous that this thing's a little too big, but. Hey, you gotta take chances in life, right? And this is one of them. Over a TV, it's worth the chance. Go big or go home. Okay, so I just went and cut that center out, like I said I was going to. And while I had this down, I took the TV mount, set it on here, and drew where the bolts are gonna go, so that I don't accidentally put a screw in the wrong spot. So I'm going to use just a 1-inch drywall screw, which is more than enough to do what we got to do. And I'm just going to kind of center that like that. Screw it in. I got a few more over here. Only a couple more in the middle. I should get one here into that metal piece there. I don't think those screws that I got though, I don't think they're going to be long enough to get. They might. Well, for now, I'm gonna try to get this hung and get this TV up in the air. Good show's coming on later. I don't want to miss it. Who am I kidding? I still watch Netflix. All right. So what I'm gonna do? I'm back. What I'm gonna do? I wish someone was here with me to goof around with. I just have to amuse myself, I guess. So here we go. Alright, so I have my marks laid out, but instead of trying to hold this thing up and doing it by myself, I'm gonna go ahead and just put a couple screws in here to hold it up in the air so I can get started. Alright. I need my glasses. Excuse me. All right, so this arm is gonna have to be in this direction. Hope this thing fits in here. It's gonna be, or is it like that? Yeah, it's just gonna fit in here. Holy moly. Okay. That's gonna be pretty cool though, right? So I get it all straightened up and all that good stuff. So now, and then I'll be able to pull it out like that and show the TV off the side of the side door. I'll have to go that way with it a little bit more. Yeah, I'm gonna have to move this over. So, let's see. Like that, I think. Let's see what happens. It's always good to test stuff out. Get carried away. Yeah, see that? It'll go watch out the side door. Could go even more, actually. But I'll be hitting that front seat, too. Well, all right. What do you think? Yeah, that's what I thought. It's a beautiful day to be out doing something other than work, I'll tell you that. But I always wanted to do this, so I'm gonna share this with you, and hopefully together we'll use it to go on an adventure. Shit. Yeah. All right, this is the boring part. We're probably gonna speed through some of this, get it over with. Fast forward. Yeah, see now the problem I have? Because this outside wall is tapered, when this extends, it won't tilt anymore. So I'm gonna either have to find a way to get this to tilt further, or I'm gonna have to straighten this up so when this comes out, it's straight. It's, you know what I mean? Boy, it's always something, ain't it? All right. All right, so that seemed to work. All I did was I added a 3/4 inch piece to the back of the bottom here, tilted this out, screwed it all back together, and it's nice and solid. When I pull this forward, it will go pretty straight. So, looks like I'm on the right track, so I'm ready for the next step. So I ran into a problem. These brackets are too close together to go around that. But then I realized that these holes, these patterns in here, line up with the hole pattern on the TV. So what I need to do is just take these brackets off and just screw it directly to the brace on that bracket. So let's do this. Okay. So, boy, I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this by myself. But I like a challenge. Besides, if I mess up, it makes for a good blooper reel. Good thing is it's light. Switch hands here. That. Oh boy, this is gonna suck. Oh, I got one in. Say that anymore? My sister does. She's a hippie chick. All right, let's see. All right, I got two. got three, man. That fourth one's gonna be a booger. Let me show you what I'm talking about. I don't know how well you can see that. You can see my, I'll put a lot of focus or not. There we go. So, I got screws to mount these are inside here. I got one here. The last one is way up inside here. I'll do the best I can to get it by hand. Okay, so what I had to do is I just loosened these up, and I just by swiveling this, I had better access to that, and I was able to get that screw in there. So now I can put this all the way back. Well, I can probably... Yes. Okay, that's back where that's got to go. Tighten these back up. Okay. So now I do this. And I have TV. It's a little crooked. I just have to move the bracket a little bit more, straighten it out. I think we're in good shape. Well, I got the stand up, I got the TV in, I put a little shelf here, got my power inverter and my DVD player over here in the back, and this thing here seems meant to go like this, see? And then I got, let's see here. See how we're doing here. I forget which remote is which. Let's see here. All right, I'm gonna play that one. There we go. Not a bad picture. Only paid $130 for that TV. Y'all love it. She still thinks of him.